So we hear that ketones are signaling molecules. For somebody like me that doesn't have a background in science, what does that mean?
Well, kind of think of it like this, like, you know, signaling molecules are ways that you can talk to tissue.
Within our bodies, all of our cells have to communicate to each other and within the cell itself by these chemical messengers. So these molecules that literally are produced somewhere and then go to another part of the cell or maybe out into the blood, into another organ, and elicit a direct effect. So tell that next cell to do something.
It impacts our genes, it impacts systemic reactions, inflammatory cascades, so it sends signals essentially in our body to influence whether a gene turns off or on, whether an inflammatory cascade moves in one way or another. So it actually works at a cellular and a genetic level, impacting different systems in our body.
And so for instance, beta-hydroxybutyrate is a ketone, and it can work directly on receptors to cause changes to happen. So it may inhibit some type of input that you don't want.
Ketones in that situation can provide 2/3 of the fuel to the brain.
That's the main reason why we have ketones, is to keep the brain alive. The signaling effects that have to do with inhibiting HDAC. It also increases the production of brain-derived neurotrophic factor. This is the factor that allows us to be plastic and our brain to adapt and change. So young people have very high BDNF.
By increasing ketones to the brain, people notice increased mental clarity, improved memory, sharper focus. People often report sleeping better, just feeling better, feeling more energetic.
The benefits are so widespread because you're shifting the energy source for the human at the most fundamental level.
I think the most inspirational thing is just there's a lot of different potential applications, and what's really exciting right now is there's a lot of work that's been done in animals, and being able to translate that over to humans, which is what I do, is what we do, is going to be really the exciting piece of things, to see how much of that can be translated over and applied to the human population.